Alright, what's up guys? Okay, so this is my second week of school. I only found out this morning that I had classes from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. So it's been a really long day of school. Okay, but to be honest, my schedule for the past few weeks has been really whack. Like yesterday, I had to rush out my YouTube thumbnail in the middle of class, and I haven't been able to go to the gym for like the past 1 week. Okay, but anyways, it usually starts off like this every single semester. So the agenda for this week is we're gonna try to fix our messed up schedule. Let's go! I don't want a Valentine, I just want Valentino. I just want the neck, I poke a face like a casino. Okay, so I'm done with my classes in school for this week, and the rest of my classes are just e-learning. So we are pretty much just gonna stay here in this room, just you and I, Mr. Camera. Okay, so today I'm just gonna spend the entire day, I'm just gonna sit here and plan out my schedule for the rest of the semester. But before we get into that, I first wanna share with you guys an underlying principle that has changed my life in terms of prioritizing my schedule, and that is, I became an essentialist. Okay, so what exactly is essentialism? Essentialism is not about how to get more things done, it's about how to get the right things done. It is about making the wisest possible investment of your time and energy in order to achieve the results you deem as essential. Okay, so I think the first thing to understand when you are planning your schedule for work or for college is that life is full of trade-offs. When you say yes to any opportunity, you are indirectly saying no to many others. Okay, so here's a good example. So yesterday I went out with my girlfriend Beat to catch a movie, and the fact that I said yes to going out and spending my entire evening out, I'm actually indirectly saying no to a lot of other things such as working out, studying, or doing something productive such as reading a book or maybe even working on this YouTube video. So likewise, if I go out drinking and partying with my friends, there is an additional trade-off that I'm gonna feel like shit the next day. If I wake up with a hangover, the entire next day is gonna get ruined, and there's just gonna be a snowball effect of unproductivity. Okay, so as much as I would love to be doing it all, I am unfortunately constrained by the number of hours I have in a day, and because of that, I need to be very protective of my time, saying no to the things that are actually taking time away from the things that are essential to me. Does that make sense? Okay, so the bottom line is this: if you don't prioritize your own life, someone else will. It could be your boss, your parents, or maybe even the toxic friends that you hang out with. Okay, so on last week's video, I received a ton of questions from you guys asking how I'm able to organize and fit so much into my day. So I think my approach to organizing my life, or at least for the past 6 months, can be summarized by this one paragraph. The essentialist deliberately distinguishes the vital few from the trivial many, eliminates the non-essentials, and then removes the obstacles so that the essential things have a clear, smooth passage. Essentialism is a disciplined, systematic approach for determining where our highest point of contribution lies, then making execution of those things almost effortless. Okay, let me draw this out. So the author describes essentialism as the disciplined pursuit of less. Everything inside the circle is essential, and everything outside of it is just noise. Okay, so how do we discern the essentials from the non-essentials? So in the book, the author uses a messy wardrobe as an example, which is supposed to depict your messy life and your career. When you make no conscious effort to keep it organized, the wardrobe will eventually become cluttered and stuffed with clothes you rarely wear. Okay, now I know my wardrobe is neat now because I just organized it, but underneath here used to be a huge mess where I used to keep my memories and my toys that I had since childhood. So basically what I did is I bought these boxes and racks from IKEA and set aside some time to filter the stuff into two categories: things that I really wanted to keep, which are essentials, and things that I could live without that were non-essentials. Okay, so likewise with our life, if we continue to allow clothes that we don't wear to clutter up the wardrobe of our life without a disciplined, organized system, then basically our schedules will continue to be cluttered and messy for the rest of our life. Okay, so how do we become an essentialist then? So the author categorizes it into three steps: explore, meaning to discern the vital few from the trivial many; eliminate, which basically means cutting out the noise from your schedule and life; and lastly, executing, which means removing obstacles and making execution effortless. Okay, now I wouldn't call myself a minimalist, I would consider myself myself to be more of a hypebeast. But if you take a look around my room, there is absolutely nothing I own that I don't use. Everything in my room is essential and brings value to my everyday life. It's much easier to autopilot like this and get into an extremely focused work mode when everything I need to be productive is within my reach. It's a wildly functional place to work and study. Okay, so I'm sure you guys are thinking, so how am I supposed to apply this to my studies and my college schedule? The book Essentialism highlights two techniques that I have applied to my personal life, and that is using extreme preparation and having a time buffer. Okay, so when the author was a student at Stanford, he would plan a calendar of the entire semester the moment he got the course syllabus in order to reduce stress and get a bird's eye view of the assignments and deadlines that were ahead of him for the next few weeks. If you guys have watched my iPad study tutorial, this is the exact same strategy that I've used for the past few semesters, and setting aside a day at the start of every semester to just sit down and do extreme planning is really powerful because this allows you to familiarize yourself with the course content and important deadlines, allowing you to plan for your weeks way in advance. So the second tip is having a time buffer. Even if you know that you have an assignment due in a week and you know it will take a couple of days to accomplish it, that doesn't mean you will be able to finish the task on time, as humans tend to have a planning fallacy where we tend to underestimate how long a task will take even when they have actually done the task before. Okay, so in order to tackle this problem, I usually allocate an additional 1 to 2 hours as a buffer time to make sure that I'm not squeezed too thin. So that was planning my schedule on a macro scale. So I will usually pen this down on my planner a few months or weeks in advance. And then we go down to the micro planning, which I do here on my to-do list in Apple Notes. Here is a screenshot of my weekly schedule from my previous semester of university. So as you can see, some things has already changed, like I no longer try to take afternoon naps because my main priority right now is to try to improve the quality of my sleep at night. So that means hopefully you get like 7 to 8 hours of sleep, which doesn't really happen. But okay, so back to the weekly schedule. So this planner or like weekly to-do list is not fixed and it's something that changes from week to week. But at the start of every single week, I make sure to spend at least 1 to 2 hours just sitting here reflecting and planning how to structure the following week, making sure that I protect the essential tasks with all that I have and spend my time wisely in order to contribute to my essential goals. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do now. So I've already listed out my entire strategy, so you guys feel free to join me in planning your schedule if you want. And I have a class in a bit, so I'll see you guys after that. Okay, so I just ended class. So today's lesson was just a recap on like the basics, so it was pretty alright. So anyways, earlier on we were talking about essential goals, so I thought I'd just share with you guys the goals that I have for this YouTube channel. So right now my main priority is I want to try to continue to be able to release a piece of informative, engaging and entertaining content for you guys every single week. So I hope to be able to continue to do this for as long as I can, and I'll really appreciate if you guys could let me know in the comments down below if you have any suggestions of what you want to see on this channel. And in fact, today's video is actually inspired by some of the comments that you guys added on last week's video, so thanks for that. Okay, so anyways, while I was packing the closet, I actually chanced upon my old hard drive from my born children days. I'm sure most of you guys don't know this, but I actually started out here on YouTube around 5 years ago with my childhood friend and current business partner, Ming, also known as Mr. Mahobos, and my brother, the rest of the boys. So we actually created this YouTube channel called Born Children, and the main goal was to kind of capture all our travels and memories and basically all the stupid stuff we did as a bunch of crazy boys back then. So anyways, if you guys are interested, I'll put a link to the channel in the description. You guys can check it out. So it doesn't really make any sense lah. We were literally just a bunch of boys just sending it. So in fact, I actually remember creating this entire pitch deck a few years back to pitch our content to like our clients. You can see here, these are our clients, our past campaigns. And in fact, Sofitel was actually crazy enough to engage our content services back then in 2017. So we actually ran a full advertising campaign for them. So that was pretty crazy. I still have no idea how it happened, but it is what it is. Okay, so anyway, since I found this, I thought why not just make a little throwback montage for you guys to see. So yep, enjoy. Looking back at these old memories, I got reminded once again that the most important thing is to live a life without regret. If you have correctly identified what really matters, if you invest your time and energy in it, then it is difficult to regret the choices you make. You become proud of the life you have chosen to live. Whatever decision or challenge or crossroads you face in life, simply ask yourself, what is essential? Eliminate everything else. See you guys next week.